Welcome to an overview of new features in ColorAnt 8. The first new feature in the custom chart tool is the linearization and ink splitting mode. This mode creates ramps for each channel and two color overprints for all channel combinations. This adds more patches to linearization charts and is intended for creating ink splitting device link profiles. The next feature is the addition of light colors for predefined colors. There is now an option to adjust the tack/ink limit to more than 400% or as low as 200% based on the number of color channels. So for example, we have 7 color channels here. To adjust the ink limit, click on the lock icon and input the ink limit amount. This new functionality can also be found in the export chart tool. And as you see here, the default order for a 7 color test chart is now CMYK OGV. Also, the generation of multicolor test charts is now much better than before by improving the patch distribution without having to increase the number of patches. The measure tool now runs its own thread and no longer prevents ColorAnt from being used while measure tool is open. As you can see here, you can use measure tool and ColorAnt at the same time without having to wait for your measure tool to complete measuring. You couldn't do this in previous versions of ColorAnt. There is a new remeasure message when measurement data is found in loaded data. The new message asks if the user would like to use the data for a remeasurement or delete the measurement data and use the reference data for a new measurement. There is also support for the X-Rite I1 ilisis 2, which has been added to the measure tool. New options have been added to the export chart tool. There are two new predefined settings. One is the X-Rite I1 ilisis 2, and the other is the X-Rite I1 ilisis 2 XL. The Add Auto Positioning Markers now has an option for the X-Rite ilisis measuring devices. This function automatically adds the required markers to the chart that are needed for these devices to perform automatic measurements. As you can see here, there is a new section called Margin Sizes. This section is where you can define margins for test charts. This is helpful as some measurement devices need extra spaces before and after a row while measuring. Another new feature of ColorAnt 8 is the ability to import a mixed CXF file. A mixed CXF file contains multiple data sets. As you can see here, this file contains LAB and remission data. A new find function has been added to the view dialog. You can now search for patch IDs, names, CIE, and DCS data. You can access the find function by selecting any random patch and right-click and click on find. Let's search for the patch ID 2701. As you can see, it will highlight that patch ID. You can also search for LAB values. Again, it highlights the patch. And as you can see, the LAB values do not have to be exact. It'll find the closest match. The ISO 12647-8 validation print has been updated to reflect the most recent tolerances from 2021. There's also a new evaluation method for digital printing called PSD, which stands for Process Standard Digital. This method incorporates the tolerances defined from FOGRA. There are two methods, one called FOGRA 2018 side-by-side, and the other is FOGRA 2018 media relative that users can choose to evaluate digital prints. The evaluation for each category is shown from grades A through C. Each grade has a different tolerance level. ColorAnt analyzes the measurement data and classifies it to the correct grade level. If the measurement value is within a specific tolerance, the grade level is displayed in each category to show that it passed. If it exceeds the tolerance limit, a red X is displayed to indicate that the evaluation failed. The overall evaluation of the print is shown at the bottom of the dialog. Another new feature is the ability to print a label. There is a new tab titled Label, which displays a preview of the label with all relevant information from the Reports and Evaluation tab. In the same tab, you also have the option to define the page setup for your label. For more information on our ColorLogic applications, please visit colorlogic.de or follow us on one of our social media channels for the latest in ColorLogic news, webinars, and color management technology.